So here you have four examples of multiplication with decimals. And the goal of this video is simply just to remind anybody how to do the multiplication. So I'm not going to give any reasons why it's done this way. I'm just simply going to show how to do the multiplication without utilizing a calculator. So let's take a look at examples 1 through 4. And whenever you are multiplying, most of the time you deal with positive times a positive in school. However, I guess in reality, you can have multiplication by a negative times a negative, or a negative times a positive, or any of the combinations. So what I like to do first is, when I look at a multiplication, I simply just check if my overall answer is positive or negative, and then I just drop the decimals and the sign itself. So for instance, for the first example, I know that the answer is positive because I have a positive times a positive. In the second example, I have a negative times a positive, so the answer is negative. In the third example, I have a negative times a negative, so my answer is positive. And finally, the last example, again, the answer will be positive because I have two positive numbers. So now, taking question number one, the decimal itself you can completely drop. So I think I learned this when I was relatively young, and simply the process that I remember was that all you have to do is drop the decimals entirely and simply multiply two whole numbers. In this case, let's start with the 4 and do the multiplication, and then we'll come back and insert the decimals accordingly. So here we have 4 times 2 is 8, 4 times 9 is 36. So I carry my 3, 4 times 8 is 32, plus the 3 is 35, carry my 3, 4 times 1, 4 plus the 3, so that's 7. Now, next I can move over to the 7. When you're doing this and you have to multiply by multiple things, so if you have 2 digits or 3 digits that you're going to have to multiply by, it's nice to have different colors or at least different shades, but ultimately it is up to you how you set it up. Having colors here is kind of nice because I can clearly see what belongs to what. So 7 times 2 is 14, and notice that I start, okay, so the multiplication below the 7 in the tens place value, so I don't start right on the right hand side like I did with the 4. So I just shifted 1 over because 7 is in the tens place value, and now I'll carry that 1. So 7 times 9 is 63, plus the 1 is 64. Carry my 6. 7 times 8 is 56, plus the 6 is 62. So carry the 6. And 7 times 1 plus the 6 is 13. And don't feel bad, because if you're doing this after such a long time maybe of not doing it, Your multiplication table is maybe a little bit off, you might be rusty. So just be patient and slowly go through the multiplications one by one. I think the key is just not to rush through it. Now finally, we're going to be adding these up. So 8, 6 plus 4, so that's 10, carry the 1. 1 plus 5 plus 4 again is 10, carry the 1. 1 plus 7 plus 2 again is 10, so carry the 1, and then we get 4 and 1. And now finally, once you finish the multiplications and then you add, you can't forget that you dropped your decimals. So all you really have to do is simply count. So we have two decimal places. So one in the first number and then one in the second number. So that is two in total. And therefore, your final answer as you proceed will also have two decimal places. Okay, one and two that I checked off there. And that's it. So now you've just multiplied the two numbers and inserted the decimal back, and you're finished. So let's now take a look maybe at example number two, okay, to give you some more insight of the process. So I'll erase this. Okay, so this is the first example. Okay, I will go ahead now and write down the second one. So in the second one, the order of multiplication is irrelevant. So it's up to you how you align these. Okay, so I will again drop the decimals altogether. I know my answer is negative already. And I kind of fell in the habit of putting the number which has more digits on top and then the number which has less digits at the bottom. I guess probably one of the reasons is that this way, okay, you'll just have three digits that you're going to have to multiply when you're doing this. So if we proceed with the multiplication, I'll start with the 5, okay, so our first one. So 5 times 7 is 35. Carry the 3, 5 times 1 plus the 3 is 8. Nothing to carry. 5 times 4 is 20. Carry the 2. 5 times 1 plus the 2 is 7. So we're done with this one. Now, I will have 3 digits. So just to make my life a little bit easier, actually, I will just erase all the other stuff, and I will just simply start, and I'll utilize a different color. Okay, and go ahead and move over to the 1. Now, with the 1, it's much simpler, okay, because multiplication by 1 is probably the easiest. I mean, maybe multiplication by 0 is easier because then everything's just 0. But by 1, it just repeats itself. So that's all that you have to do there. And again, notice that I start my 7 underneath the 1, okay, because it's in the tens place value. Okay, so that's what happens. So you have to just shift it over. So now let's move over to the 3. So I'll shift that over. And let me, since I erased by mistake there, the line. Okay, so our next one. So with 3, so 3 times 7 is 21. Okay, so carry my 2, and again, so notice that I start right underneath the, okay, so underneath the 3, because now I'm in the 100 place value. Now 3 times 1 plus the 2 is 5, nothing to carry. 3 times 4 is 12, okay, so carry the 1, and 3 times 1 plus the 1 is 4. And now you can go ahead and add this up together. I will say that depending how you have been taught, Some people like to put zero here to fill in those place values, but it doesn't really matter because when you're adding, okay, so kind of column by column, the zeros are not going to do much. So you're going to get 5, 8 plus 7 is 15, carry the 1, and 1 plus 1 plus 1, we have 3, 7 plus 4 is 11, plus the 5 is 16, and then 1 plus 1 plus 2, we have 4, and then we have the 4 remaining. So in this case, you know, we can't forget that the answer was negative. Okay, so that was right there. And then simply counting the place values. So we have 2 in the first and then 2 in the second. So in total we have 4. So our place values, we should have 4 place values. Place values, decimals. Okay, in the number. And you always start from the back, and then you just count. So in this case, there would be 4. So that's example number 2. Okay, so let's move over to example number 3. So I'll just erase this board here for us. And we can take a look at the next one. So again, if I drop the decimals, I get rid of the negatives, I'll have 856 multiplied by 24. Because I dropped the decimal, the zero in front is irrelevant. So now again, you can just simply go ahead and begin. So 4 times 6 is 24. Carry your 2. 4 times 5 is 20 plus the 2 is 22. 4 times 8 plus the 2 is 34. So that's our first one. Now our second one, I guess I have only 2 digits, so let's move over to the 2, okay, with the blue color. So 2 times 6 is 12. Carry the 1, 2 times 5, 10, plus the 1, so carry the 1, 2 times 6 is 16, plus the 1 is 17. So here, once again, I can just add it. Again, it's up to you if you want to put a 0 here or not. So this is 4, I guess 2 plus 2, 4 plus 1. 3 plus 7 is 10, carry 1, and we have our answer. So the answer is positive, and now, so counting off, so 1, 2 decimal places in the first number, 1 in the second, so therefore you'll have 3 decimal spots, okay, in your answer. And that's it. Okay, so that's all that you would have to do for this one. Okay, so let's go to the last example now. Okay, and try to see what happens there. Okay, so here. Okay, so I'll just erase this stuff that we have. And okay, so I'll write down. So now notice I'm gonna just drop the decimals here, and if you drop the decimals, you know, so this would be written in this way, but the leading zeros are irrelevant. Okay, so it's still 409, and then of course the second number is 3018. So again, I'll just simply put the number which has more digits on top. That's just preference, nothing else but that. It's just a habit that I have fallen into, I guess, and whoever taught me when I was younger probably did it that way, and most likely it was my wonderful teacher, Mrs. Petit, when I was still in Poland learning this stuff. So here, okay, so if you go ahead and multiply, so we'll start off. Okay, so we have our 9, so 9 times 8 is 72, so we'll carry the 7. 9 times 1 plus the 7 is 16, so I'll carry my 1. 9 times 0 is 0 plus the 1, it's 1. And then 9 times 3 is 27. So we're done with the first one. And now, so maybe I'll just erase this for clarity here. So now you'll notice that, so we have a 0, we didn't have really a 0 before. But multiplying by 0 just gives you 0. There's many ways of trying to approach it, but if you're systematic and you do it the same way as we have done the previous three examples, you know, you can just simply go ahead and multiply each digit by 0. So 0 times 8, 0 times 1, and 0 times 0, and then 0 times 3. Okay, so you just get a bunch of zeros. And now, so shifting over to the 4, so again, you're going to start 4 times 8 is 32. Okay, so notice you're still aligning under the correct place value. Okay, so this is aligned right underneath there. So it said 32, so carry my 3. 4 times 1 plus the 3, 4 times 0. Okay, so it's 0, and 4 times 3 is 12. So now you can go ahead and add them up. Okay, so let's do that. So we have a 2, 6, 1 plus 2 is 3, 7 plus 7 is 14, carry the 1, 1 plus 2 is 3, and then 2 and 1. And so going back, now you have to be careful because we have a lot of decimals here. So our first number had 4 decimals and our second one had 1. So in total we had 5. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Okay, so that would be our answer that we would have. It is positive. Okay, and this is what you would get. And now, you know, the likelihood of doing multiplications by hand is not extremely high when they're this complicated. But if you, you know, if you are forced to it, if it's either in school or somewhere else where maybe you're stuck without calculators, it can happen. You know, you should at least know how to do the multiplication by hand. So just take your time and be patient. You can look through these and hopefully these examples just provide you more insight on how to do it and that is the actual process. Okay, so thank you for watching, everybody. So my name is Bartek and hopefully this helped you a bit. Okay, so have a wonderful day. Take care. Bye-bye.